Okay, in this section we're going to talk about different techniques for watercolor painting. There are three basic techniques that everybody needs to know to do almost any kind of painting. We are going to talk about wet on wet, we're going to talk about wet on dry, and dry on dry. So those are your three basic techniques that you really have to get good control over. And with those, you can just about do anything you want. And then after that, we'll talk a little bit about some special effects. So to get started, you remember we have to wet our paints. I've got clean water here. I'm going to squeeze a puddle of water in each of my colors. I don't touch the paint. I just want to squeeze the water, creating a puddle so that the paints will become activated. Because really, watercolor doesn't do anything if it's hard and dry. I never use black. If I want my colors darker, I combine colors. All right, so our first technique is a wet on wet. And what would that mean? You must have wet paint, because it doesn't work, as we talked about, it doesn't work unless it's wet. But you also have a wet paper. And we did this one in the first section, because it's a very useful technique. You use clean water, wet the paper, and if you remember, the paint will only go as far as the water. And then I apply my colors. Wash my brush between colors. And allow the paint to move on its own. They're going to mix and blend and bleed together. You can guide it a little bit. You can roll it around. But as you can see, color only follows the line of the water that was on the paper. Now that's pretty intense. If I wanted to do some softer technique, I was going to do a sky. I would wet my paper, add my color, and maybe guide it. Guide it down the paper. Get a more muted result, and it would look more like a sky. That's wet on wet. I use that a lot, especially when you have large areas like a sky or a lot of background grass, or if we were going to do water, we use the wet on wet and let it do a lot of its own thing. It also has a really nice tie-dye look or abstract look. Wet on dry. This is the technique that most kids and adults are comfortable doing. Maybe it's the one that they are most familiar with. But this is when you have wet paint, still doesn't work without being wet, but you leave the paper dry. With this technique, again, the paint can only go where the water is.
So it will stay exactly where you put it.
By pushing down on my brush, I can get a wider line. By lifting up on my brush, I can get a very thin line. But with the wet on dry, the paint isn't going to move around. It's going to stay exactly where I want it. So this is very good for details. Smaller areas. Because it's going to stay right there. And put little eyeballs, little smiley face. It's not going to move. It's going to stay right there. And I can get some very small details and into small areas. Now, if I was going to do that on top of a wet-on-wet background, though, I'd have to wait until it's dry. This area right here is almost dry. I could, let's see what I can do here. So maybe now I could add my tree, and it's dry enough that that's not going to move. And I've added details to a blue sky background. But you do need to wait until it dries enough. Okay. Our last technique on the basics is called dry on dry. So this doesn't have a lot of use. Dry on dry doesn't have a lot of use. It requires that the paints are not soaking wet, that the brush is dry, and that the paper is dry. So I would use a brush like this. Get some paint on it. And then you use it for special effects. It's good for grass. Could be hair on a dog. Just a scratchy area for grounds. You want it to look dry, you want it to look scratchy. So it has very limited uses. But you can't get that kind of feathered look if your brush is really wet and your paints are really wet. You need to be able to have a dry brush, fairly dry paints, and very dry paper. So you'll get that feathered effect. Okay, I'm going to give you a few minutes. I want you to play with your papers. I want you to play with the paints and your brushes. Try a few of the different brushes. I've got my big square one. I have my big round one and my medium one. And for the little teeny tiny details, I would use my very, very small brush. If you have a fan brush, that would be really fun to do with a dry on dry. I didn't get mine out today because I was going to use this one instead. So take a few minutes. Experiment with the wet on wet. Experiment with the wet on dry. Get some details. And then try that dry on dry and see if you can get hair on the back of your dog. And I'll be back in a few minutes.